Hi guys, it is time for another one of your replays, and this time we are featuring Lihush again. Now, Lihush is probably the most featured player on your replays, but he just keeps on sending these amazing games in, and it's gotten to the stage now where the game has to be amazing if I'm going to consider featuring Lihush again. And he's done it again. Another amazing replay. This time we are in the T20, and it is a confrontation battle. It's Americans versus Germans on a tier 7 game. Lihush is top tier at tier 7 in his T20, and a heck of a lot of Hellcats and Jacksons on his team. But enemy team have a lot of Tiger P's, Tigers, and TDs as well. So it's quite close. It's a 56%er. We are here on Muravanka, and we're just going to play.
Let's go!
Now, the T20 is a tank I still have. It was a tank I decided to keep. And I think it's the first American medium I actually enjoyed playing, and as a result, I decided to keep it. In retrospect, I do regret keeping it. I do regret paying money for camo. I only put camo on tanks I'm going to be keeping, but because the Pershing is a much, much better medium tank at tier 8. But that doesn't mean the T20 is bad. The only thing I don't like about the T20 is the fact it has a pretty slow reload for a medium tank. Rather than that, it's quite punchy. It's got 160 pen with 240 alpha damage. So Lihush is not running Sixth Sense here. He has been spotted and someone just took a shot at him. So no shots at the guys on the hill down in H9. But the T20 is pretty mobile, and Lihush is running gas in his tank, which makes it even more mobile. So a Jagdpanzer IV is spotted, and a VK. Pretty nice snapshot on the VK. But lots more tanks down here, so Lihush is just popping up, taking a shot, and popping back down. Stug pens his turret, unfortunately, and he misses his return shot. The T20 does not have the best armor. But it is pretty mobile. Trying for a cupola shot in the Tiger 1. And bounces on the VK this time. Just a shot went a little bit right and hit the gun mantlet. Jagdpanzer. Okay, another shot goes in. Tiger P needs to hit him in the turret. And unfortunately misses that shot. No idea where that shot went. But Lihush is using his very, very good gun depression to get shots at these guys. But it is 4-5 at the moment. Lihush's team are losing slightly. Trying to get shots on the Tiger 1. Decides that no, he's not going to poke the top. He's going to expose too much of his tank, so he's just going to work the corner instead. Unfortunately, misses the Tiger 1, and Tiger 1 puts one in. Jagdpanzer is killed for the first kill of the game for Lihush. There we go. Nice shot on the Tiger 1. Tiger 1 bounces. Fortunately, fails to pen the Tiger 1. But pulls out, and there was the aim time. The aim time on this gun meant that Lihush was exposed for a long time. before he was able to fire, and as a result he took another shot from the Tiger. I think that's the only mistake Lihush made in this game. He probably should have stayed in cover till his gun was loaded and then popped out and shot, but it doesn't matter. He's got a second kill. So he's down to 486 health now. T25 in the distance.
Gotcha.
There we go. Kill number three. Lihush's team have pulled it back. It is now 9-8. So, three tanks versus a Tiger P. Oop, and then RT in the distance. Another good shot on RT. Is he going to get the kill? Nope. Tiger P is tracked. Shot into the cupola. Lower glacis. Good shot. Okay, so Lihush is up to four kills. It is 11-9 and things are looking pretty comfortable. It doesn't stay that way though. So a Tiger 1 has appeared behind Lihush and has taken out the T25AT. However, Lihush makes the decision to go back and defend rather than focus on the Tiger. Side shot in the Tiger P, that looked as if it went a little bit high. Okay, nice snapshot before being fully aimed, and one of the Tiger P's is down. Replay's a little bit bugged, so you can't see the outline. There we go. Trying to go for the lower glacis. Thankfully, it went high and hit him on the turret. Good shot on the lower glacis. And a blind shot that looked as if it went very far to the right. So, Lihush is up to 5 kills, and of course his RT is accusing his team of being a noob team. So, it is 2v3. Now, unfortunately, that Hellcat that is with Lihush isn't the sharpest knife in the drawer. 193 efficiency, 43% win rate. In 8,000 games. So it's cat and mouse. Lihush knows there's a Tiger 1 defending their flag. Oh, and as he turned to find out what the Hellcat was doing, Tiger P put a shot in. But the Tiger P's on low health. So it looks as if Lihush's blind shot earlier actually hit him. And Lihush gets his top gun. Nice shot onto the commander's cupola. Yeah, it's definitely looking as if this Hellcat is a bot. So it is pretty much Lihush on his own. That Hellcat's going to be no good to him. Definitely a bot. Gun pointed opposite direction and just driving randomly. So Lihush has a Tiger 1 and an... what is that last one? A PZ SFL-6C left. So, Lihash is advancing to where the Tiger 1 was last spotted. But no sign of him. Okay, there he is. Tiger 1 misses his shot. Lihash fires on the move, doesn't hit, and then uses this rock down here. Looks as if the Tiger 1 has a stock turret. Lihash goes for a blind shot. And now it's a standoff. Who's going to move first, the Tiger 1 or Lihash? So Lihash is firing blind at the last known position of the Tiger 1. Ooh, Haystack has just collapsed. Tiger 1 is advancing. And now they're being capped. So really, really difficult situation. Lihash really, really needs to kill this Tiger as quickly as possible. As I say, the Hellcat is a bot. Tiger 1 is advancing. Lihash puts a shot in. Pulls back into cover. Another good shot. Tiger 1 is still advancing. Is that Tiger 1 reversing? The Tiger 1 decided to reverse directly towards Lihash. And then misses his shot. Lihash senses his moment. Okay. Finishes the Tiger 1, but the enemy team are up to 50. It is not looking so good. And if Lihash had not been running gasoline in the T-20, what's about to happen would not have happened. So, Lihash is desperately racing back. One enemy tank left. He either needs to stop the cap, or he needs to kill the enemy tank. Now, once a flag is captured, there are still a few seconds left where you can decide the game. So, 94, 95, 96, 97. Lihash needs to kill this guy. Base is captured. But Lihash kills the last remaining tank in the few remaining seconds. And there we have it. An ace tanker, Radley Walters, high caliber and top gun in the T-20. I told you this game was special. Lihash, you just keep doing it to me. Lihash finished top on XP by a huge margin, 1,802 XP, 4,357 damage, and 8 kills. He fired 33 shots, 27 were hits, and 22 went in. He received 6 hits and only managed to bounce 1. He received a potential damage of 1,285. He damaged 12 of the 15 enemy tanks, destroyed 8, and even managed to do 2,030 spotting damage. He was not playing with a premium account, which is a shame, which meant that unfortunately he lost money on this game. He lost 9,000 credits, but he did earn 1,802 base XP times 2, which left him on 3,604 XP for the game. That would have been a much, much better game with a premium account, and maybe he would have made a bit of a profit, but that doesn't take away from a fantastic game. So, not only was it a ace tanker, Radley Walters, high caliber, and top gun, but he didn't get the Defender's Medal. He did 100 base defense, but unfortunately the base had already been captured at that point. But I'm going to give him, just... in my heart, I'm going to give him the Defender's Medal as well. Thanks for watching. I'll see you next time.